That is crazy.
Look, let me come show the camera.
That's the QB wide receiver connection right there with an insane pass.
Oh, yeah, I always dreamed of being a quarterback.
You have best not the same every day.
Man, these are good memories.
This has been, I'm pushing Jamal.
This moment has been a lifetime waiting.
Double bang, yeah. Appreciate that, Mike Breen.
What does it mean to be him? That's what we want to know.
When I get a cut, I'm top five.
Amazing moment for sure. 29-74, ain't counting.
Young B. This is my first points in the NBA.
Bradley Beal sends it and hits it for three.
It was a three. Look at that. I gotta get back to that. Catch and shoot three. I think I only had like 6 or 8 points or something like that. And I didn't shoot it great. I got to play against D. Waiters. D. Waiters was in my draft class. Feels like it was so long ago, though. Man.
The last couple years. So it's just a breath of fresh air that they have some NBA talent on the floor like Embiid.
My first game in the NBA, probably the most meaningful one, because there was so much hype going into the season about, you know, me missing 2 years. And I mean, people never thought I would play an NBA game in my career based on, you know, the injury that I had. And a lot of excitement. And, you know, that was my first bucket in the NBA. That was a great time for me because, you know, there was so much excitement about me and that game, and, you know, I was glad to just be on the floor and, you know, kind of reward the fans for, you know, waiting that long for me.
This is definitely when I had no hair. I used to try to rock the, like, the low cut, baldy, like, coat.
Double D.
Yeah, this definitely was a time, man. I remember my parents getting hyped to be there. It was two things I remember from that game, getting a block on Shaq and getting that circuit bucket.
My first NBA basket, I actually know what it is before I even, I think Trevor Ariza, and I'm coming downhill at him. It was just a blow by and a layup. I think both of my first two baskets were actually layups.
This is my first game?
Jaren Jackson Jr. puts his name in the scorebook in a regular season game for the very first time.
It was all layups. Like, I just made sure, just like, no dunk, forget all that. Just put the ball in the basket somehow. This kid's 19, so he's just trying to figure out what he's doing. This person is still somewhat the same, you know, in ways. Better clothes. It's a big part right there.
It's my first NBA bucket, first NBA field goal. My first points were a free throw.
Back the other way, Halliburton off glass. Thought about it in midair.
This is so funny because it's Drew Hanlon, my trainer. We always mess around about how I always jump looking to pass. And he always yells at me for that. He's like, you need to look to score first. And this moment right here is like, it encapsulates everything about me. I'm like jumping to pass and I realize it's not there, so I end up shooting it. A bucket I'll never forget, and something I'm sure that, you know, my kids and grandkids will be looking at for a long time.
They just handed me this play, and they want a reaction.
Crush the Warriors. Draymond Green, his first NBA basket.
My first field goal. I had some free throws before that. I'm going to come out of the corner to the top of the key, and I'm going to hit a three. You know, some of my favorite people in my career were on the court with me here. Gotta love it, baby.
NBA's first bucket.
Made a nice adjustment at the hoop and got his first NBA basket.
This was against the Wizards, one of my old teams. Let me see if I can explain that move. It was just like a 1-2 step, drove baseline, little razzle-dazzle.
That whole thing was a blur, not gonna lie.
Jalen Brunson, the rookie from Villanova, second round pick.
Welcome to the NBA.
You know, I didn't expect him to even play that night, but I wanted to be there for his first game. And then when they put him in, you know, I got excited. Then he made a big shot. This is a big shot. It's great. Opportunity came knocking. Hit a big shot. I came on the game. I'm just happy the ball went in. I don't take for granted. Coming to work every day has been, I'm had a bad day yet. You know, just to see him at work, so it's fun.
Record breaker in Madison Square Garden.
Here's Curry for the record. It's good! And there it is! Stephen Curry!
Knew it was coming, just didn't know when and where, and to do it at the Garden was definitely fun. Reggie and Ray in the building, my mom, my dad. What's crazy about that play is we ran that play maybe 100 times. I've never gotten that shot off of that play ever, and that was the one time. Amazing moment for sure, 29-74, ain't counting.
DeRozan against Grimes, puts up the jumper, it's good, and a foul!
Game winner versus the Knicks, and I'll never forget. Couple possessions before this, I had bust my lip real bad. I remember being in this position. I was like, only way I feel better is making a shot. I just knew I was gonna make it. Like, just being in that moment, being in the mecca of basketball arenas, this is probably one of my favorite game winners, especially with it being in the Garden. And for me, the Garden is my favorite place to play.
Game winner in Washington.
Two to tie, three to take the lead. Shea checks, steps back, 3-point shot on the way. He's good.
We're down big in that game, crawled back into it. And then late game, we were actually up and Bradley Beal hit a jumper to go up one, or go up two actually. We had a play and I just wanted to get to my spot. Set him up going right to get back left. And I made a shot I was comfortable shooting.
This is the shot against AD.
Jokic just gets it off in time. It's up. Oh, it's good! Anthony Davis just stares at him.
I kind of made a couple of these during the playoffs.
Sabor Shuffle! Got it!
I told to the media, I'm going to take it. This is my shot. It's a signature shot.
It's off the Smart for the seventh game.
Down 3-2 in Miami Conference Finals. 3 seconds left, and we call up a play. They double me, and Smart catches the ball, and he shoots it, and I just run to the basket. And me and D-White both jump, but it goes his way. And I remember just falling and just being like, oh, my God. He just starts going crazy. And for a second, I was like, it's too good to be true. Like, there's no way, because I could not believe the emotions of that game and how we won to give ourselves another chance.
Shea gets it, spins away, baseline shot. Shea puts it in and walks it off in OKC.
Another game winner. We were down and crawled back into the fourth quarter. And then I wanted to catch the ball in the corner late game just so that there wouldn't be any help going left. Great play by coach and great pass by the inbounder. And all I had to do was make a shot.
Bang, bang, Randall knocks down the three.
Double bang, yeah. Appreciate that, Mike Breen. I heard he doesn't give out too many of those, so I'm glad I can be on that short list of double bangs.
Randall on the drive, stripped by Butler. Randall gets it back. Randall puts up a three. Bang, bang, Randall knocks down the three.
Tibbs looking mad. Teammates running after me run over Tibbs. There's something special about that Miami weather and playing in Miami during that time, so you know, I had a little extra juice at the end of the game.
Bang! Bang! Randall knocks down the three!
This right here was an amazing time, man.
I mean, it's cliche, but this might be one of my favorite highlights I've ever had.
Tatum against James. Tatum for the title.
Oh, man. Playing in Crypto Arena Staples Center. You know, my favorite player played at Boston Lakers rivalry. Down 2 with 20 seconds left and got the rebound. And it was me and Bron, one of the greatest, if not the greatest player of all time, you know, and somebody that I have a great relationship with. Just in that moment, one-on-one, go between my legs, behind my back, I lose the ball and I get it back, hit the shot, we go into overtime to win. That's the moment that you live for.
Fox, 2, Fox from midcourt, got it! De'Aaron Fox called game!
Yeah, the game winner against Orlando. We were actually down by like 20, I think, in the first half. We came back in the second half, made a game. I don't remember how much I had in overtime, but I was feeling it. The whole time going down the court, I was thinking like, I'm gonna get to a spot and I'm just gonna race. In this moment, if you miss it, you just go to a second overtime anyway. So there wasn't too much pressure on that shot.
You grow up, you're like Michael Jordan played for the Bulls, so you want to have a good game when you're in Chicago.
Halliburton, a deep three for the lead, it's good!
Like, I never played good against the Bulls. I always just say that, I never can play good against the Bulls. This is only like my third game in Chicago, and my other two weren't very good. And definitely a special moment, something I'll never forget.
We going back to the game against Portland.
Embiid driving, spinning, fading,
I think the whole game, we were down like 15, 20 points. We ended up making a run. From that point on, you know, you gotta do whatever it takes. I just went on and, you know, did the best shot possible.
The steal, Edwards got it off in time. Oh, are you kidding me?
Yeah, I remember this game. He's just getting hot. I remember him getting a little fast break dunk and he windmilled it. Man, you just see how special the kid is, man. His rookie year, we was playing against Minnesota, and I remember he was getting mad late in the game. He wasn't getting the ball to, you know, make the big plays. And I remember telling him during the game, it's like, man, don't worry, your time gonna come. Your time gonna come. And, you know, to see where he at now, being an all-star, it's definitely amazing to see, you know, how far he came in such a short amount of time.
Artest looking, gets it to Bryant. Bryant dribbling, has to put it up with the buzzer. Banks it in! Oh, he banks in the three!
Luckiest shot ever. Kobe Bryant hitting the game win on me.
What can I say? I just hit a lucky shot.
One-legged, fading away, off the top of the key. It was such a Kobe moment. I actually couldn't be that mad because I looked down and said, that's Kobe.
We actually shot behind the scenes of him telling you that.
In the back.
I was gonna be mad at you, then I said, then I realized.
I realized it was him. I looked, I was like, oh, that's Kobe. Yeah. You know what I mean? Yeah. I was hot though. If it was anybody else. D-Wade,
what's up, bro?
You see the laugh or cry? I don't know what's supposed to do. I'm laugh. Hey man, you're the only person. I'm like, look, anybody else, I'd have tore that locker room up.
Steph versus CP. He did the behind the back, the between the legs. Behind the back.
Curry splits the defense behind the back. Fires a three.
This is my first year coaching Steph.
Yeah, that was crazy.
Every coach that I ever had in my life, their voice was in my head saying, that's a terrible shot. That's a terrible shot. That's a terrible shot. Keep in mind, this is like the first couple of months that I coached Steph Curry. So you see me on the sidelines, I'm holding my arms up. I'm thinking, Phil Jackson, Greg Pop, their voices are in my head. Lute Olson, this is a terrible shot. What I eventually figured out is that it's a great shot because it's Steph Curry. The numbers don't lie. That's a shot he makes over 40% of the time. So I finally realized Steph gets to shoot whenever he wants.
110 to 102. Nash goes down. Wheels in the corner. What a pass. Hill with a three.
That's tough right there. That's Steve Nash.
Talk about a great assist.
Behind the head. Back when he was going to lay it. Ooh, man, that's tough.
This pass is crazy. He's the reason why I love the pass so much.
It's Lillard. He got the shot off. Lillard got it. Good. And the Blazers win the series for the first time in 14 years.
The game winner against the Rockets. A little confusion off the ball. This the one that gave me chills right here. Because I was just young. This was my first playoff series. A tough team, tough matchup. If we would have lost this game, that was game 7 in Houston. We was going back on the road. So. Yeah, this one gave me chills.
Oh, okay. I was coming back when I was hurt, and I was trying to work my way back into the game, from the very first start of the game. And I never thought I could get in rhythm. I never thought I was in rhythm the whole game. And Pat said, look, he gave me the ball and said, hey, go win it for me. This play we drew up, he said, go get a shot and win the game. And that's what I did. They wasn't expecting me to make that shot. Even my own teammates wasn't expecting me to make that shot. But you know what? I always dreamed about that way back in the courts and shooting over somebody when it's 22 up and you shoot it right in their face. You say, game, just walk off the court. That's what that was. And hey, that was just clutch right there. Look at Pat. Pat always loved when we were with the Knicks.
Smith to inbound. Back to Doncic. Doncic pulls up, three-pointer. Bang! Bang! It's good! Doncic wins the game at the buzzer!
I don't know how he does it, man. He's just amazing. Sets people up. That step back is automatic for me. I'm like, dude, I would let him drive. I ain't let him step back for a three because he stepped back with his three. That's money.
Zellers has Jordan. Jordan with 2 seconds to go. Puts it up. It's good at the buzzer.
Oh, this one, MJ over Elo. You don't even need to talk about this. It's just the magical moment of basketball.
Final seconds. Bulls look for the win. DeRozan to win it. Good!
Game winners. What's crazy about my Indiana game winner was I came down and I was hoping I got the switch and I was going to try to turn the corner on a big man. But as soon as I seen him recover back to Vooch, I looked at the shot clock and I just knew I had to get a shot off. And this whole night, it was a struggle. I think I had a bad shooting night and I didn't have no legs. And I just remember telling myself, if I try to shoot a fadeaway off 2 feet, I'm not going to get it to the basket. So as soon as he recovered back in front of me, I just went off one leg, shot it like a regular shot, hoped it went in. It was nothing but net.
Feeds DeRozan. DeRozan, pump fake for the win. Got it again!
The play was actually for Zach, but they switched it so well. Kobe was taking the ball out, and I made a noise to Kobe that I always make in practice and everything. I made a noise to him. He knew to pass me the ball as soon as I made that noise. And I knew one of them was going to go for the pump fake. I just needed to get somebody in the air and just look for a clean shot. And I got it off and it went in. I couldn't believe it, especially the night before hitting the game winner. But that them two shots was definitely crazy. The Washington one was definitely crazy because I just did it the night before. So the way that panned out was definitely crazy.
I'm him! I'm him!
One of the best moments in my career.
Reeves, 21 points, gets inside, off balance, jumper, got it!
I'm him! I'm him!
Prime was giving me the ball, and in my mind the whole time, I was just thinking, like, I can't mess this up. This is pure reaction, though. I didn't think about it.
What does it mean to be him? That's what we want to know.
I don't really know. I mean, I play off so much emotion that, you know, things just happen on the court. Tapped a really good fourth quarter run for me, and I don't really know. It's just what come out of my mouth.
When I get a cut, I think I'm top five.
So in my third season, I was mic'd up for a game talking to my old teammate, Javonte Green. I just got a haircut, and I told him, you know, when I get a haircut, that I'm top five. And he asked me, he was like, top five what?
Top five.
And it could be top five anything. Top five basketball players, top five in looks, top five most stylish. Just the confidence that you have when you get that haircut. That has went viral, and when I go to away arenas, people always yelling, top five, top five.
Last time I was on the mic, I had a fresh cut. But now I got curls.
So what?
Same rule apply.
That still holds true to this day. When I get a cut, I'm top five.
This one is the MVP trophy ceremony. This one meant a lot to me because, I mean, my son being there. Fatherhood has been best thing ever. I mean, you know, since I became a father, I feel like my life, you know, my life was going in the right direction, but I feel like you went in an even better direction. Having someone else you care about, you know, between my wife and, you know, my son. Watching him run towards me was, that was a sick moment. Couldn't hold on, and, you know, I started tearing up. It was a great moment. Wanted my family to be part of it. I'm just glad that, you know, that we're able to be part of, you know, accomplishing something meaningful.
And I remember her just begging me to want to be at this game, begging me to want to be at this game. And I said no. And it's so crazy because halfway through the game, I didn't even know she was yelling like that until OG, man. OG was running back down court. He had just missed a couple free throws. And we running back down court. And OG tells me, man, tell your daughter to leave me alone. And I'm like, what's she doing? And the next set of free throws, I heard it.
And there's DR doing work.
I'll tell you what, she's keeping them to about 50%.
They need to put her on the payroll.
For the rest of the game, the whole second half, I heard her scream every single time. You know, that was definitely a cool moment that I got to share with her for forever. You know, even just hearing people now randomly just say, man, I love your daughter. Your daughter, you know, is a star just from that moment. So it was definitely cool. She definitely was feeling herself after the game, for sure.
Tatum gets a good look for three. That's good.
I hit a three early in game six of the finals 2 seasons ago. And Deuce was excited for me and screaming, seeing him grow in my career and his life. He's become quite the star of the Garden.
Who's your favorite player?
Daddy.
It still doesn't get old. It's a lot of times I'm at the free throw line and he's screaming my name. He wants me to wave at him. He wants me to acknowledge him. And I always go like this. I'm like, yo, you gotta pay attention. You gotta watch. Those moments of him cheering on his dad and him being excited, the moments I always remember. You know, I love having him courtside.
Yo, I just think whatever my dad does is funny.
He probably thought of that wave all night.
Meanwhile, Jarrett Jackson Sr. being honored as the Spur alum of the night.
During this moment right here where we're hugging, we were already losing the game. I was looking up at him during the game like, don't let us go back in the crib right now, dude. I'm telling you.
biggest comeback in franchise history on the road. Jersey swap every game.
His legacy and mine coming together.
We're going all the way back. This is actually the first year I started playing basketball. Yeah, I happened to have an opportunity to go to Basketball Without Borders in South Africa, you know, a couple months after I started playing basketball. Back in 2011, you know, having the opportunity to be around, you know, NBA legends and learn from them and, you know, just trying to soak as much as possible was great. Man, these are good memories.
Oh, I remember this because my dad's at the end of the clip dancing.
Halliburton with a sweep on and pops.
Enjoying this game. He enjoys this game.
You know, I think it just encapsulates our relationship. And the worst part about it is that he has a shirt, a Pacers shirt on, that he put my face on the sleeve. My pop sport means everything to me. You know, him being able to sit courtside and be immersed in the game and enjoy the game, and we're able to communicate throughout the game. I think that he really enjoys it. I really enjoy it too.
Off balance three, and he puts it in! Wow! Tyrese Halliburton, the ascending superstar.
And how about Papa Halliburton there?
That's my boy.
Look at the Beal boys. They're off 94 feet. Let's go.
My boys. Seeing them always courtside at all my games is, it's crazy how they want to do it, and I don't push them to do it. These little guys, man, they keep me motivated, they keep me going. They're always happy, they're always joyful. Like, you can just come home, you can have a bad game, they come home, they don't care, you know, and it's nothing like that. I love those boys to death.
Big red boot fit obviously went viral. Yeah, everyone was going crazy, wanted to try them on, wanted to know if they were comfortable. They actually were. I got them before they released, and I just wanted to wear them before they got to the public. I wanted to do it in a sick way. And every year is fun, walking in the tunnel.
Yoke trying to get me in the pool.
This is when I'm pushing Jamal. I wanted him to throw him inside.
You know, all your life you try to capture moments, and that's the one moment that's, you know, forever captured in my memory.
Good times. You have lots of jump now, I think. Yeah, fun time.
I think when we win it again, we're going to go back in the pool.
I remember this.
Just seconds remaining. Nance defends, double teamed. Got it! Oh my goodness!
I'm about to stand up, I turn and there's a baby in my face. So I was just like, what's good, homie? Yeah, I seen him again. They blew up the picture, I signed it for him, so it's a special moment.
Just a little better.
Great shirt.
Yeah, he's a clown, first of all. Josh is a clown.
I think it, don't do this again, bro.
I'm just eating. Stop. He's asking don't you a question. Mad at me for.
Thank God we haven't done any joint Dutch conversation since then, because he just goes for the clown around the Anton. Whether it's he finds something.
We genuinely love each other. We want the best for each other.
We don't really have a relationship. It's just a coworker. We're going to call a teammate. We're calling him a coworker. We do our best not to see him every day. We try our best.
This right here, my second year in the league, rookie, one of them, I just know that was when I dunked on Dwight.
Chris Paul taking it right at Dwight Howard.
That was crazy. I always said, because I dunked on him, I'd never try on anybody else again. And that was an and one, so yeah, that was tough.
This is the dunk. That's the one, man.
Floats. Oh! Holy cow, what a punch!
I did not know the bounce was going to be like that. And you should always crash because you never know. It could be something that is in your career forever. Yeah, that's probably my favorite dunk. I can't come up with anything.
Dunk on the Pelicans.
Durant! Oh my goodness! Get up or get out the way! I lost my voice, but I'm a founder on that dunk. Oh my goodness!
I remember this dunk. My defender jumped to the screen, forcing me left. My instincts just kicked in. Now, a split second, I knew I had to drive. Getting downhill. Whoever was in my way, I was going to try and dunk on him.
So that's a clip of me. I don't remember if I blocked the shot or just, I think I touched it. I don't know.
Wemby staring him down, and he forces the air ball. So there's the defensive impact. Nice rim run and the punch.
Just me disrupting a shot. My teammates getting rebound. A nice transition pass from Julian. Me dunking. I knew that was going to be my last game and I had to go off on a good note, so just me putting energy on the court.
Struggled. Bust. Oh! Derek Dynamite!
It's funny,
I was actually going to lay this up. I knew Kelly Olynyk was going to go straight up to try not to foul. As I was up there, a layup would have been hard because of how high I was. It was really just a split-second decision. I knew I had to dunk it or I was probably going to miss the layup.
I'd probably say this is my favorite dunk of my NBA career.
Oh! Halliburton throws it down!
Oh, no, you missed it, partner. It was the dribble.
In high school, I did something like this. Me and my friends used to call it like the yo-yo. Right after the game, I sent it to him. I couldn't wait. Chris Paul does it all the time. You like act like you're gonna pass it and keep the ball with you. I don't know if you call this a poster. I don't know, but it's a dunk, and I don't have many of those, so it's a good highlight overall.
I don't think he thought he was gonna actually get the ball, and when he got it, he knew exactly what to do with it.
Look, let me come show the camera.
Drive to the elbow, kicks the weak side. Here's Edwards, left alone. He'll drive the baseline, rise up and hammer it through. What a finish by Ant!
I kind of saw the play happening and caught the ball. He kind of almost got hit in the face with the ball. As he was going for the steal, I was just praying he didn't jump. He still jumped.
You go for a steal, something may happen if you don't get it.
It was a hustle play.
Probably one of the best dunks I've ever seen in my life.
No, this was nice.
Murray's got KCP, and he throws it down, and the crowd goes crazy.
I remember this whole bench was crazy. Passage from Jamal was just, he didn't think I was gonna catch it. It was a nice one though. We actually had three dunks in a row, which was crazy.
There are 50 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Starks, yes! What a move by Starks!
That's John Starks, man. He's a good guy, I like John. People say he dunked on Michael, I don't know though. I don't know if Michael was in the frame. I mean, he was in the frame, I don't know if he was under or not.
Here we got a dribble drive, change of direction by Bryant. Slam dunk.
Woo! Kobe, when he dunked a preseason game, I remember watching all his highlights and, he crossed the dude and dunked on him.
You talk about elevation. Chick, he went up to the rafters.
Jason Terry, good defense. Wade from behind takes it away. Chalmers, pull.
I was a part of this moment when LeBron, RIP, Jason Terry in the Garden. We all love that moment because JT liked to do this a lot. But he got dunked on that night.
Y'all got that steal too.
And here he goes.
Here we go.
PG.
What you got?
Puts on the shot.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. PG.
Yeah. The 360 windmill. Yeah, this play was, it's ironic it's against the Clippers too. The backstory behind that. My teammates all week been clowning on me. And they're like, man, in a game, you're a boring dunker. Like, you don't do nothing. Like, you always get fast breaks and you always just, you know, one-hand dunk, two-hand dunk. So before this game, I'm like, I got y'all. Like, I'm gonna do something special this game. And it just so happened I had the opportunity, the fast break. DC threw me the ball and the rest was history. We made something flashy out of that, so. Shout out my teammates for pushing me to the limit to do something crazy.
Now there's the problem Rollins has. He fakes at times when he should just take the ball. Whoa! Right to the basket. That was Doc Rivers.
Now this I can watch all day. My highlights? Are you kidding? I didn't even know we had highlights. You know, we were still on reel to reel when I was playing basketball, so this is really good stuff. I can watch this all day. Playing for the Hawks was awesome. You know, the fans were nuts. Kind of old school.
He maximizes players' ability. In transition, Wade finds James!
Okay, I'm watching the Christmas Day special. LeBron and the Heat playing the Lakers on Christmas Day. That's crazy. Now, yeah, this is crazy. This is high-level basketball right here. Off the glass, D-Wade throwing it to LeBron, so that's what they were known for, so this is high level right here. I do remember watching this game. I was in my living room as a little kid with my little brothers and my parents just watching this on Christmas Day, so yeah, I do remember this.
Ahead to Lamar, the lob, the jam! What a punctuation mark in this one! Oh, me, oh my!
Hello to D Miles. This is like the time where I became a Clippers fan. Like, watching them do stuff like this, like, they just had a different connection. The energy was crazy. They were underdogs, and they were all young guys. So I really enjoyed watching the Clippers. But that play right there, I was like, man, like, we tried to recreate it in high school. Like, throw it up, try to go get it. We were just doing crazy stuff like this, watching plays like this from the Clips. So, yeah, this was
He's one of my favorite throwback Clippers plays right here.
Robinson goes to work again. Good job by Nesby. And for the jam!
I remember this one. Keith Kloss made a real bad decision. He tried to go up top with D-Ham, and it didn't turn out well at all. We had Glenn Robinson on our team, and Big Dog was a perennial 20-point-a-game scorer back mid to late 90s through the early 2000s. And I used to play alongside of him. I was one of the first small ball power forwards. They used to have to be cross-matched with sometimes 6'11", 7-foot guys. So based on my physicality and verticality, I felt comfortable, as this clip showed.
One of my favorite NBA moments. Ooh, never gets old. You know what I love about this moment? Reggie Miller. Welcome to the Kodak moment. Andy Bell.
And Dwayne Wade right at the body of Anderson Varejão. Welcome to your Kodak moment, Anderson Varejão.
Very special moment for me. Jordan was at the game. First game Jordan came to see me play personally as a Jordan athlete.
He and his game are.
Getting the offensive rebound. And lead!
This next highlight is what I would probably call the best poster in my career. I always like to think that I missed a free throw on purpose because I knew this was gonna happen. And I mean, George was pretty unselfish to just set me up for that highlight. So like I said, that's probably the best dunk of my career. And that's one of the dunks that I've always dreamed of, because, you know, looking at Blake, you know, back in, you know, in his Clipper days, you know, him throwing the ball just in the hook. I've always wished I could do that. So I was kind of glad that I got that opportunity, and that was probably the last one.
Rudy Gay with an offensive rebound. DeRozan spins, 360. Oh, hit him with the sauce.
360 layup. I remember cutting, and Serge stepped up so high. My first mindset was to dunk it, but Serge stepped up so high. My natural instincts just kicked in just to spin, and I was just hoping I didn't mess it up, but that was.
Oh, the good old days. Finley, Nashi. Oh, wow, one of my few dunks. I tried to jump over him, didn't have enough hops.
Here's Nash to Sean Marion.
Ooh, Steve Nash throws me a lob over Dirk. Ooh, man, watch your head, Dirk. Watch your head. But this is truly special.
Roger Mason to Jefferson. Monroe Obama!
They didn't give me many options. I had to come up with something because I was running out of bounds. And with the side of my eye, I saw Duane coming through the middle. So I just threw it as hard as I could and as quick.
He's the first round pick of the Hornets. Off it comes to Haslam. Rejected. What a defensive effort that time. Unbelievable. And Marion finishes at the other end.
Got a block on Udonis. And then I raced. I beat everybody down the court. I didn't beat everybody down the court, but I was still able to get a dunk. Oh my gosh, that was a pretty nice play. That boy got skills.
Tatum drives down and throws it down. Wow!
First play is Game 7, my rookie year, when I dunked on LeBron and chest bumped him. I think that's the play that people remember most. Or ask me about most, especially kids. Kids always ask me, how does it feel to dunk on LeBron? So I get asked that all the time.
Here we go, Tatum. Giannis switches onto him. Tatum and Antetokounmpo, the superstar. Step back three on the way. Oh, it banks in! Jason Tatum puts Boston on top with a window three. How about that?
First game of the season. It was 0.4 seconds left. I think we was down one. Down one or two, we had like 13 seconds left. Took the ball out on the side, and I remember during the timeout, it was kind of clear, but, you know, I told Brad, you know, just, you know, give me the ball, and we we got a switch, and I had it in isolation, and you know, I got to my spot. And it was a big shot. You know, first game of the season, everybody's excited.
Oh, what a pass from Tatum, and Williams with the finish. That was sensational.
The next clip, I got the steal against the Lakers at home, and I was falling out of bounds, and I threw it behind my back, no look, to Rob, and Rob caught it in stride and dunked it.
Smart, looking for Tatum. Gets it in, Tatum takes it, makes it!
And the next one is a game winner in my third season. One dribble pull up over RJ Barrett, former Duke at home.
But you nailed that last shot. Is that exactly what Coach drew up in the huddle?
Yeah, we had a bunch of different
options. Let's go, kill up! Let's go, kill
up! My man right here.
Now here's Crawford the other way.
Great ball. Jamal Crawford with the double behind the back tap. Ooh, over the, when I saw that move, and I was coaching that game, pap, pap, pap. I mean, Jamal Crawford had the double pat behind the back, crossover, sweet.
That's where John Starks faked and that comeback. That, yep, this is it.
Jordan trying to shake off Starks.
Best part is that he was dunking on his homies too. Like MJ was just going at all of his homies and letting them know it. That I think that's the one of the coolest parts about the game.
Shot is taken by McCray. It's blocked by the Lakers. The ball rolls free. Magic wants it. Magic's got it. Bounce on it. Randle scores.
Uh-oh, you got my guy. Oh yeah, here you go. I know what he about to do. Oh, give it to him. Oh, don't you do it. Oh, bounce pass. Ha! That's magic. It's showtime.
The floor. What a pass.
Oh, snap. I didn't even know Charles Barkley could pass like that.
That brilliant pass from Barkley.
105-99, 18.7 seconds left. Miller for three, and he got it. Reggie Miller with a clutch tray, and it's 105-102. And a steal. Miller retreats to the three-point line and hits again.
This is what made really Spike Lee be quiet. Reggie was just, he was that guy. You know, we talk about clutch performers. This guy is always going to be in my top five.
15 on the shot clock. Down low for Dominique. Baseline drive, Dominique. Oh!
Dominique is different. The double pump off 2 feet, off of a 1-2, that's tough. That's so tough.
Oscar has Collins on him. 3 seconds left on the 24-second clock. Collins on the floor.
Hustle play to steal the ball. You know, that's what I feel like the Celtics, that's what we're known for. You know, getting our hands dirty, playing hard, especially for our home crowd.
Shot clock runs down to five. Tatum saved it. Oh, and a play by Jason Tatum. McGee's got his own miss. Tried to spin, stripped to the ball by Curry.
Oh, no.
Pass to Durant.
Steph, we have an assist. Here it is. Oh, don't you do that. Durant with the dunk. Good pass, Steph. Good pass.
Lord have mercy. Every time he plays, I have to stop, watch, get me some popcorn. Steph Curry, must-see TV every time he plays for me.
Ooh, since 1957, Bob Cousy. Ooh, yeah, okay.
Bob Cousy has dazzled countless fans with his thrilling brand basketball.
Oh, good pass. That was before my time, but listen to me tell you, Bob Cousy was a man.
Iverson has Jordan. The crowd is into it. Allen shakes free, gets two!
Iverson crossover Jordan, which is, you know, I mean, when he came in with this crossover, no one had seen this type of crossover in a game before.
Take a look at the crossover. Mike said, oh! Allen said, yes, the bucket, the crowd loves it. Roger Mason to Jefferson. Mamu, Obama!
Ginobili. Oh, don't you rip him like that. Now give him back the ball. Oh, there it is. Oh, good pass. Great pass. Ooh, ooh. Ooh, behind the back. They was fooled. Al Jefferson, what are you doing? I don't know what he was doing.
Look at Harrington. He's talking to Pierce. They're talking to each other. Come on. Bring it, big fella. Show me what you got. Pierce pulls up for a three.
Pierce buries it. 2003, he's talking to Al Harrington. I feel like he told him what he was about to do. Talking to him, sidestep Trey Ball in the garden. Something I might do.
Yes, Joe, young fella.
Tatum steps back to his left, three in the air, splash! And right in front of Paul Pierce, Jason Tatum just gave him a Paul Pierce to end the third.
Shot clock. Rodney Rogers, his pass is stolen away, and it's Williams again. Working on Chapman behind the back of beauty. Phenomenal pass to Weber.
Oh, White Chocolate. Oh, he used to do dimes. The White Chocolate used to look, look. Ha!
Ooh, White Chocolate J. Will came in with the behind the back sweet stuff. And what made it so bad, J. Will, when he was in Memphis, oh, I got to pause. I got to talk about J. Will. Because J. Will playing for Hubie Brown in Memphis. You talking about culture clash. And Hubie was like, hey, number 55, know what he doing out there. Running, passing, dropping dimes, doing his thing. J. Will, White Chocolate. Love you, brother.
Losing streak.
Oh!
Oh, man, not my boy Tyler. Sham God. That was tough. Late in the game, too. It's one of the flashier dribbles that you'll see, and you don't see very often. And if somebody does it, it's like, if you're going to do it, you're going to do it with intention. You know what I'm saying? That's going to just do it. So when he did it, and the move actually worked, and then he dimed, it was a nice play.
Brown runs into Wallace. Wallace goes down, but there's no foul. Billups winds up with the ball. What a move!
In the NBA Finals against the San Antonio Spurs, which is 2005, it was one heck of a series. And I'm on the fast break on this play, and I used the fake behind the back pass because I'm a guy that I wasn't very athletic, so I had to use little tricks and everything to get my shot off. And I wanted to just make Robert Horry on this play kind of bite for it, to buy me a little bit of time to get the layup off. And it was a pretty nice highlight. It was something that I used to do way back in high school, and who would have thought that I would be doing that same move in the NBA Finals.
Brown the drive. Jaylen Brown kicks it out. Smart fakes. Inside, Tatum spins and puts it in.
I think that was just a sign of how we came together as a team, you know, in the last couple months of the season. You know, we started moving the ball around. We started playing with each other a lot more, because in that possession, I think we were down one. We just got the rebound. I was calling for the ball at half court. JB pushes it. He easily could have, you know, took the shot. He passes it to smart pump fakes. And instead of, you know, staying still, I initially thought he was going to shoot it. But once he took the dribble, you know, I cut behind the defense. We locked eyes. And he threw it just perfect where I had time to make my spin move and lay it up. And that was just great basketball, you know, with no timeouts. We didn't draw anything up. Game on the line in the playoffs. You know, that was just a hell of a play.
Spins, loses the dribble, still has it. McLeod for the win. No! Spurs have won it. Spurs
win! Oh, wow. That's pretty cool. That is so cool. Pop's first win. I forgot I was a part of that. I remember when he took over, no one had any clue that it would turn into what it's turned into. But the one thing I do remember about the moment when he took over and he started to lay the foundation for the future, we just knew that things were going to be different. We knew that more was going to be demanded of us. What we didn't know is that we'd be having a lot of fun. And none of us knew that he would be more than our coach. He's been a father, mentor, uncle. In some of our lives, he's been a bit of a go-to. And so when I look at something like this, it just brings a lot of joy. As you can tell from the gray hair, I've been around for a little bit. So it's just pretty cool to see all the faces, Sean, Vinny, AJ, 5-0, Malik, Corey Alexander, all the coaches there. It's a pretty cool moment.
Looking for their 46th victory of the season and their 28th in this building. Green crosses over Vince.
Why not?
And delivers to tie a franchise record with the 11 straight made field goals in the same game.
So I do remember this moment. Once again, I think this is like late in the season. We're making our playoff push, and I got hot. Thankfully, Monty, knowing me, he ran a lot of plays for me to get to my left hand. Having Chris on the team as well, guys were looking for me, but it was one of my better games where I got going against Phoenix, and finished the game with, you know, 20, 30 points, something like that. So fun times here in New Orleans.
Those lungs are burning. Your legs feel like noodles, but you gotta go on.
Steps back a three. Ooh. Bang! Whoa! He is taking it to Stephon Marbury right now. Both these guys with 31.
We was playing in Madison Square Garden, and of course, like I said, everyone wants to play well in the Garden. And playing against one of the point guard greats, Stephon Marbury. And, you know, the game was on the line. We were up 2 points for, I think, 20-some seconds. And, you know, I make a move and kind of do the yank back and make a three-point shot to send it, to put us up five. And it was the best game I ever played in my career in the NBA. A game sealer, but also having 32 points and 10 assists. That was a huge game for me. But whenever you have your career high, it seems like it was yesterday, you know, because you always remember that game. And especially doing it in the Garden against, like you said, Stephon Marbury. And it was a great night. And so thankful for that night. And I really enjoyed it, especially getting the win.
C-stick for Larry Bird. Bird with the left hand, and it stays. Left hand, right hand, both hands.
Yeah, I remember this one. Larry started out this game against Portland. I think Jerome Kersey was guarding him. He scored the first 8 or 10 points left-handed. Now, Larry was ambidextrous. He did almost everything left-handed except shoot a basketball. And the funniest thing, one of the funniest things that I ever heard sitting on the bench was Kevin McHale, after Larry scored, you know, 4 or 5 baskets in a row left-handed to start the game, he yells to Jerome Kersey, running back down the court. He goes, "Hey, Jerome, wait till he starts shooting right-handed."
It is Michael Jordan time. Scottie Pippen looking for Michael Jordan. Checks the clock, 5 on the 24. Here's Jordan, did not have the shot. Curry does, in it! Shoot! 5 seconds remaining!
What goes through my mind when I see this clip, and they'll show it on NBA TV sometimes. I'll be at home and I'll be, you know, working the clicker, and this will come on. And I just think to myself, thank God that thing went in.
When we called timeout with 25 seconds to go, we went into the huddle, and Phil told Michael, he said, "Michael, I want you to take the last shot." And Michael said, "You know, Phil, I don't feel real comfortable in these situations. So maybe we ought to go in another direction." And then Scotty came in and said, "You know, Phil, Michael said in his commercial that, you know, he's been asked to do this 26 times and he's failed. So why don't we go to Steve?"
The play was for Michael Jordan. Phil Jackson's a very smart man. So, yeah, the play was for Michael. But part of the deal playing with him is that you know people are going to double team him, so you got to be ready.
It's hard to hyperextend the skull.
Jared Jack, in and out, no good. Oh my goodness! Oh my goodness, Willie Green!
Okay, so I remember this. Years ago, playing against Portland, it was like a Monday or something crazy where we just didn't have a ton of energy, but I was able to get going that game, give us a spark off the bench, and honestly, the ball bounced off just the right way. I was able to catch it and finish it with a nice putback. So, you know, maybe one of my only dunks in my career.
Yes, indeed. That's Mark Blunt. Yeah, Mark was physical and tough too, so I knew I couldn't lay that up. He would ping your ball against Jerry West in a heartbeat, but just playing on this team, whenever you got on the floor, you knew you had to go hard. The Detroit team being coached by Larry Brown and all the teammates I had, Ben, Shee, Chauncey, Rip, Tay, Lindsey Hunter off the bench, we knew we had to go hard, man.
Over 100, that would be the Sixers' advantage. Doc Rivers with the
luck happens. You know, every once in a while you just grab it and you throw it. You know, I will say this, and I don't do the generation thing. In our generation, we are better, because I don't actually believe that. I think the guys now are so much more skilled than we were. I really believe that. I think the next generation will be more skilled. But the one thing we always did, we didn't worry about our field goal percentage. We took the shot. We didn't care. If I got the ball and it was 2 seconds, We always said, throw it up to the rim and give yourself a chance. I threw it up to the rim, I gave myself a chance.
This is probably the best play of my career so far.
His skill set is, wow, see what I mean? That's just amazing.
Yeah, that is crazy. 3 years ago, two of my teammates, they had a bet between each other. Is Victor gonna shoot a three, miss it, and dunk it someday in his career, whatever. And so after the game, I called one of my teammates and said, yeah, it happened, finally happened.
Check the replay.
Yeah.
Oh, I see that boy, Brun.
With my first pick, I'm gonna go with Anthony Edwards.
Oh, nah, that was crazy. Yeah, that was crazy. He picked me first and he had all them other stars up there. He came in there talking about some, I'm gonna let the young guns do it. He getting old, man. He turning into ump.
This moment has been a lifetime waiting.
Look at that.
Look at him.
Oh, yeah. He's doing the D-Lo.
It's how you become known as the best big man shooter ever.
3-point contest. I'm guessing this is the last round because I remember how my shooting stroke felt and it was perfect most of the shots. So I always asked the NBA if they gave me a chance to be in a 3-point contest, I wouldn't disappoint. And I was a man of my word, broke the final round record and held by the greatest shooter of all time, Steph Curry, and found a way to get the job done.
This was the moment where I got crowned the MVP of the league. It was special, not because I was the MVP of the league. Everything that I went through, losing my brother, you know, missing all these years, you know, starting playing basketball, you know, what, 12 years prior to, you know, this moment. As far as being a role model for my son and setting up the good example, you know, that was part of it too. That moment was special, and I'll forever remember that.
Joe told me he was going to dunk on me in the locker room in the All-Star game because we played in the first game out All-Star. He did try.
Another one, a feed.
Oh! Rejected, erased inside Jackson.
I'm just going to run it back real quick. Yeah, I used to block shots when I was younger just because I wasn't getting the ball. So I just figured out a way to get the ball because my team was so good when I was really tiny, like 8 years old. I mean, there'd be no need. I was the big guy. The other teams would never even cross half court. They couldn't bring the ball up. We'd win by like 100 points. And eventually, they'd get past, and I'd block it, and that would be like my highlight for the day.
And damn it, Booker.
Okay, Booker.
A special effort defensively tonight.
I like it. He gets it, and you can tell he wants it bad. He wants to win bad. Like, I've battled him for years, and now I get to say I get to join him and help him as much as I can.
Oh, that's a big moment, yeah. Can't win the steal, can't foul.
Stolen by Caldwell Pope! And a foul!
Seen it coming.
Two clutch free throws from Kentavious Caldwell Pope!
Well, it was the toughest two free throws I ever made, though.
Okay, so we're going a lot of the back.
Made that, virtually still all the line.
Here comes Brunson, looking for the shot, gets it off. Goes classic count!
First of all, why are the shorts so long? I didn't have a lot of moments like this. I didn't play a lot. You always make fun of me, but no, hey, I'll definitely move over. What shoes are you in? I'm like, here, give me some, my first or really personalized shoes. All right, that's it.
Oh, yeah, I always dreamed of being a quarterback. That's the QB wide receiver connection right there with an insane pass.
Book breaking out his quarterbacking skills.
And when he caught it, I thought he was going to catch it and fall to the baseline, but he caught it and brought it right and still made the shot. One hand catch, I mean, to gather and finish it in that amount of time. We didn't even talk about that. He was just like, and I knew what he was doing. Somebody like that brings the best out of you. You want to match each other's greatness every day, you know? If he's making shots in practice, you want to do the same. You know, if he's making shots in workouts, you want to do the same.
Probably one of my favorite passes to my guy, Colin Sexton, in Detroit.
And what a pass from Garland.
Full court pass, four court bounce pass. That's one of my favorite plays that I had so far. Right on the money, too. That was a dime.
Yeah, I was definitely feeling myself this day.
The Halliburton effect.
Before the game, they announced that I was an All-Star. So I was definitely feeling good going. I think it was my first game back from my arm injury, too. Hence why I'm wearing the J.J. Watt elbow brace on my arm. Yeah, I was definitely feeling good that day. So there was definitely some extra put on that didn't need to be. But if it comes to the highlights, I like, for myself, assist stuff because I just like seeing my teammates win.
game winner in Philly.
Inbound to Smart. Bounce pass Tatum. Tatum puts up a three. Bang!
It was a tough game. It's always tough when we play in Philly. They had a great team and a great crowd. Joe drew up a play, threw a great bounce pass, and came down and stopped on the dime, kind of silenced the crowd.
I didn't know it was possible that night.
This is the 12th 70-point game in NBA history.
I actually thought we were going to lose that game because we were down by like 20. Donovan, he just snapped it to that mode.
Mitchell for three. Oh, unbelievable.
Just scoring so many buckets and bunches like that. It was super dope to see. But I mean, when the ball hit the rim off the free throw, it was a great tip. So he just ran and got it and just tipped it back in. I mean, that was a crazy moment. And it was for games, so it was a big win for us. Great performance from Donovan as well.
Yeah, Korea 9 against Utah.
The fifth most points in a game in Sixers franchise history.
It was fun. I like dominating. I just felt like I was in a groove, scoring buckets after, buckets. I think I had 59 points, 11 rebounds, 8 assists, and 7 blocks. Pretty good night. I was just glad that we got the win because, this would not have been the same, without the win.
Loose ball was tracked down by Lee, then a great steal. How about that catch by Marion that slinks it up the floor to find Terry for the slam and foul?
Okay, we playing on Dallas Mavericks. I get a steal. Ooh. And I throw like a half-court bounce pass to Jason Terry for a dunk. Man, that boy got skills.
And now you see why he doesn't want to change it. Oh, wonderful heads-up play by LaMelo. Saved it to Biz, gets it right back, shoots a pass over to Rozier, and the reverse is good!
My goodness.
Yeah, on this one, T-Rug gonna leak out and just thread the needle. Hey.
The Heat have gone cold. Ginobili on the finish! Flushes it with the left hand.
This was a very, very special play for me. I had a lot of disappointment. I was hurt because of what happened the year before. And for me and the whole team, that NBA Finals of 2014 were very important. And that play kind of shows that there was something in us that was not going to let those finals go past us and not having the trophy in our hand. The celebration was pretty good. With TD rubbing my my head to celebrate, it was pretty funny.
Here's Davis. Oh boy!
Jermaine O'Neal, my buddy. We play high school basketball on a traveling team, so I had to. That was a good dunk, man. I dunked on Jermaine O'Neal.
Kid can't see over the top, and he can't. I'm here to tell you, kid can't see anything right now. Feels like he just ran into a mountain. Kid to throw in, it is a long.
J-Kid throws me a lob for a game-winning shot against the basket. That was dope in Dallas. That was dope. Against the Houston Rockets. Oh, you should see the faces on Houston. They were sick.
I don't believe it!
What a play.
Need a shot, need some points quickly. Sato for three. Oh,
big three by Sato. They get some defense here. But they got a steal.
Takes that right back. The Bulls with another chance. LaVine!
Oh, stop it!
Playing the Hornets, broken play. We were down the whole game. I was hot, was making a lot of different threes, difficult shots.
LaVine lost it on the way up, regathered, and still hit it. It's been that kind of night for Zach LaVine. 11 made three-pointers.
Toward the end of the game, we didn't have any timeouts. We got to a two-point game, and we doubled them. We got a loose ball, and in my head, I was just going for the win, so I just backed out for the three, and and not much to be said about that.
Nashburn, who could run the baseline, Davis, that'll be counted on a shot attempt. Oh! It's got to go!
That counts! It.
It's good! Baron Davis has just fought it in from 92 feet away.
He got the record for the longest shot in the NBA. I called it. Told my teammate I was going to make it, just throw me the ball. And as you see, Eddie Robinson has his hands up because that is the teammate I told to pass me the ball.
Davis is there, picks his pocket. One on two, will he go all the way? Yes, I got it! Oh, facial on the star!
And then, that was my first big dunk in the NBA. I got a chance to dunk on Kevin Garnett, Hall of Famer, the big ticket, one of the best defenders in the league.
Right by Cliff Robinson, Delk delivers to Dudley for Marion. Oh!
Oh my gosh, play from Chris Dudley. I dunked on, this is my second year, I dunked on Al Harrington for an and one.
61-60 Utah, Wilkins with 5 seconds, drive, with 3 seconds left.
There's one against Mark Eaton where I go around him and go up and pump fake and, wow.
Got it on the ground and still made it. Davis the draw, my goodness.
Oh, pump fake, in and out on Reggie, 360. Once again on Jermaine O'Neal. You know, we had these big rivals against the Pacers, and Jermaine O'Neal was a great shot blocker. And for me, it was like, you know, I wanted to be the person to challenge the shot blocker.
And Duncan, two clutch free throws. He will not call timeout. Marion has to put up the three. Put it in at the buzzer.
We're playing in San Antonio, fourth quarter. Steve hits me with a pass. I pump fake, get Ginobili up in the air, and I shoot a three-pointer and tie the game up to go into overtime.
3.5 seconds. Marion gets it into Wade. Marion back, puts it through, and the Bulls unable to foul before the basket by Marion. Steal nearly made, and that'll do it. And the Miami Heat with a dramatic road victory.
Oh, I remember this. This actually was my last game for the Heat. D-Wade, I passed it in to D-Wade. He passed it right back to me for a backdoor layup for a dunk to win the game. That was my last game in Miami, actually. I remember that like it was yesterday.
This is Atlanta's game. Spud, Dominique, overpowers.
Another one against Boston. It was Robert Parrish, one of a close friend of mine. We wasn't that close then, but I had some really good dunks against Boston, man.
Couldn't get anywhere with Parrish. Dominique fires outside, goes after it. Whoa!
Fun stuff. It's good to have these archives so you can show your kids and friends, like, just what I used to do.
Shaq spins. Oh, the extra move! He dunked it!
Goodness.
And he knocked David down.
The stories that I've heard from David Robinson was that he was extremely strong. So to be able to watch this highlight, then basically see what Shaq was able to do to someone like, you know, David was is pretty insane. You know, when you hear, like I said, when you hear stories about how strong he was, and you know, for someone like Shaq to be able to do this to him, that's very impressive, and that just shows you how dominant Shaq was. It didn't matter who was guarding him. He was just better than you, and he was going to dominate you.
Here comes George, got the step, and Spoelstra, what a move! It counts on the foul!
The backstory behind this, this actually has a backstory too. B. Shaw, our assistant at the time, he was on my behind for, he always would say, like, you need to play 6'9", you got to play 6'9". Like, I would go in there, I get blocked, like, you playing 6'2", you playing 6'3" right now. So that was in the back of my mind. Like, when I go to the basket, I gotta go finish this. And I gotta play above the rim, or I'ma hear it when I go to that bench. And so, sure enough, I was able to beat Brown off the bounce. And that was the only thing on my mind was, I don't know how I'ma do it, but I gotta go dunk this. And I didn't even see Birdman. I just knew I had to go down there and dunk this. And so it ended up being probably my biggest play of my career. The environment was crazy, the game was crazy, the energy was crazy. So yeah, I finished it, and it's an iconic play for me.
For going for steals. Hero, the rookie, the 20-year-old. Layup, up and in, and the foul! A little pause, a snarl, and a chance for a three-point play.
It just came to me naturally, honestly, it just happened. I don't even know how to do this again. I drove left, and I got an and one against Rondo, who is someone I, you know, grew up watching a lot. So, yeah, I was excited. We were in the finals. I was playing the Lakers, and I made a face.
Well, he's their second leading scorer. They need some help. Long run out by Kobe Bryant. What did I just see?
Here we got Kobe's
behind the back, like 180 dunk against Denver. My favorite part is they got scored on. So Robert Horry throws the outlet pass and, you know, Kobe's going down the court. And I think just the creativity of, you know, most guys would have went behind their back. That was the easy part, going behind your back, could have just reverse laid it up. But, you know, with him being who he was, you know, there's not many guys clearly that could do that. Throwing down the court, taking one dribble behind the back, you know, 180, you know, that all happened in 2 seconds. You know, it's not many guys that can do that.
Ewing's pinned him down low, getting 13 points, 8 rebounds. He's just playing with so much confidence. Good job there. Now, Doug Christie stepped in. John Thomas. Oh, my goodness! From the hip, Vince Carter.
I remember watching this game. Anything Vince used to do, it was one of those things to where, like, it never seemed real. It just didn't seem real. It was just like he was making up stuff on the fly. But for him to do this off one leg, palm the ball, windmill on a fast break, you could see T-Mac reaction in the back of just, come on, man, it was ridiculous what he used to do every time.
Isaiah Thomas has not done the job tonight. Hardaway backs off on Thomas. What a move! Oh, did he explode and it goes! That was brilliant!
Oh, yeah, this gets my idol right here. I put it behind my back. I had him. I was like, ooh. I said, hold up, Ray. Let me stop. Can I stop it? This is what I said when I saw Isaiah. And I said, this is my chance right here. Right here. And I never set nobody up on a crossover. Never. I was coming down. And when I cleared it out a little bit, I said, oh, yeah, I got him. I said, I'm going to do this crossover on him. And after the game, he was like, you shouldn't have done me like that. I was like, come on, Z. Come on, man. But he said, I like what you did. I'm glad that you did it, but I'm your man. You shouldn't have done me like that. Like, you're my guy, Z. You're my guy. But you know, got to win.
Carlisle, three, not in a good position to do much. Throws up a prayer and hits it.
Well, fumbled the dribble. Had to fall to the corner and then shot a fadeaway long two-point shot against James Worthy. It's interesting, this game was the best game that I had had to this point in my career. I scored 10 points in a national TV game against the Lakers in 86. I happened to have a really good game, which was, very much probably not something people would have predicted, but it was a huge moment for me in my career.
Mavericks again push the ball, 4-on-2, and it's Kidd. Oh, Monty Williams, a spectacular turn away.
Oh, wow. You guys are digging into the archives here. Where'd you guys find this? Pretty cool for me because on this particular team, we had a ton of injuries that year. It allowed for me to play a ton of minutes that year. And I think that's Jason. Yes, Jason. So that's pretty cool. I'd love for our players to see that. But that was my role. I could score the ball, but my biggest impact was defensively, getting after guys and making plays, which nowadays they call winning plays. I felt like that was my contribution to the team. And so this is pretty cool. I hope my boys see this because they would love to see their dad making a play like that.
Anthony Davis over there.
I remember this one. I think it was my first game winner in 2015. Against OKC.
It'll be Anthony Davis. And the buzzer. Yes! Yes! Oh! Anthony Davis!
Game winner. The three, top of the key. And the funny thing about this game winner is that this led until the playoffs. So New Orleans and OKC was tied at the end of the regular season. And this game winner actually gave us the tiebreaker. And we ended up going to the playoffs over OKC. So it was a big shot.
Danny Green, long, D, what a play, showtime!
And the pass from Danny Green, the dunk on Aaron Baines, 2 seasons ago, that was, I like that one, that was a top play.
In that game, but then came back, AD on the reverse, how about that live boogie, Danny?
The live from, what was it, DeMarcus, right? Yep, from DeMarcus in New Orleans. I caught the ball, did a 360 alley-oop. I don't know how I did it, we talked about it for a couple days after. He said, bro, how did you do that? I said, I don't know, just instincts. I just caught it and you threw a little short, so I had to get it and turn. I don't know. But it was a hell of a play.
Yeah, I think he ran that off.
Here goes AD. Hold it down. How about a poster? Anthony Davis is on fire.
This is my first poster. That's my second year in the league. I remember this. On Big Baby in Orlando. I caught a pocket pass, went up and dunked it. It was the first time. I was still very, very skinny. No hair, had like a, I don't know what I had going on with the facial hair. But ended up dunking on him and I was hype. Everybody was hype, so it was good. It was a good one.
In the third, after only six over the first two quarters of play, take it and make it.
Oh yeah, I remember this. I wanted to dunk it. This is the behind the back against Portland. Ed Davis fell and Shabazz hit the floor. He touched the floor a little bit and then got the and one on Zach Collins. So that was a good play because I think this summer is when I first started working with guys on my ball handling. And so I put it to great use right there. I wanted to dunk it, but he fouled me. So I just, like, it was like a little sloppy layup that went in. But it was a good play. It was a good play. It went viral like everywhere. So that's when I had handles. I already know this one. This is against Boston.
It'll be Gordon on a crossover. Gordon at the buzzer. Tipped home, Anthony Davis. Anthony Davis followed it beautifully.
Yep. The game winner tipped it in over KG. I think it was like 0.4 seconds left or something like that afterwards. 0.3. Eric Gordon went to shoot the layup and I got the tip in over. And I was so hyped. I think actually that was my rookie year. So that was my first game winner. I remember like being hyped and I saw like time left 0.3 and I'm like, please don't make a shot. Like, please don't go in because it just ruins the whole moment.
End of the shot clock. Pondexter waited a half hour. Anthony Davis cups it and throws it down. Not bad timing.
This one, I don't think I remember this one. Oh, y'all finding all the old highlights. I had a one-handed putback against Atlanta. I don't really remember that one, but it was a hell of a play. And we got the game winner against Denver. A
lot of time here.
2.1 seconds remaining. Denver a foul to give. Jokic trying to disrupt Rondo. He puts it in. Here's Davis, 4-3 in the win. Oh, it's good! Anthony Davis has won it for the Lakers!
The good thing about this play, it wasn't supposed to go like that. It was a broken play. Ball was supposed to go LeBron at the elbow. But I just saw my guy drop off and me and Rondo kind of made eye contact and I was able to just fly around and he put the ball on the button and I caught it and just shot, just let it go. And we end up winning that game and eventually winning that series. Yo, Kobe at the end too, so that was, and we had the Black Mamba jerseys on, which is pretty cool. And I remember this one, this is the one-handed alley-oop against New Orleans.
Head.
That was a good one. Then actually on this play, I got so hyped and I run it back down the floor screaming and my gun fell out and like I tried to catch it and I think it was like on video of me doing that too. So yeah, man, it's a nice little highlight tape. We're gonna have more highlights to come for sure.
By what? Oh, he's hit by Popovich. No foul ball.
This is iconic. The, you know, on Cleveland, going out of bounds to throw it on the other side of Sasha and be able to throw the lob to big fella, to Shaq. Definitely also one of my top five favorite plays in my career. That was a park move right there. We used to do that in the park.
Hold up the drive. Gonna try to go inside on Harrington. And
rookie year, playoffs, dunk on J.O. I was talking my stuff on this one. This one I was starting to come into my own. This one I knew I could be a darn good player in this league in the second round of playoffs my rookie year.
Not a good matchup right here for the Heat.
Thomas, Wade with a steal, with two. Wade puts it up for the win. Yeah, baby! He did it! Dwayne Wade with the steal and the game winner.
Game winner versus Chicago, one-legged three-pointer in overtime to say this is my house against my hometown team. That felt great. Probably my favorite NBA on-court moment.
One of the great moments, one of the great plays made by one of the game's greatest players. Can you do any more than Dwayne Wade has done?
Daquan Cook has tripled four times in tonight's game. Miami's ahead by 13. Wade saves it into Beasley, gets it back, lobs it for Cook, who smashes it. What a play!
Eric, that's the play of the year right there, baby.
2008 playing with Michael Beasley, Mario Chalmers, Daquan Cook. These kids, they brought some joy and some excitement and energy, and so that play right there was just us having fun.
His jump shot is off, no good. And pass to LeBron.
Full court pass to LeBron in Indiana. I say about 92 feet. Legendary. Legendary. I mean, you know, I was a backup quarterback back in the day. I shouldn't say backup, but I was a backup quarterback. Spin on Perk, probably my second best legendary dunk. And Perk was disrespecting me a couple nights before, so I thought I'd add a little disrespect back to Perk and hit him with the...
The building was standing in true appreciation.
Look out, Ademeyer on the pick and
roll, blocked by Wade! This is good if it goes! Yes!
What I love about this is the reaction and expression from the crowd, man. You know, watching everybody get so excited about this block on Amari and then just this heave that as soon as I let it go, I knew it was cash. I was just waiting for it to go in.
Two-man game, Odom, Eddie Jones. That's who Miami normally goes to try and get something going down the stretch. They let the rookie handle, Wade out in front, trying to create off the dribble.
By Wade putting the move on Davis. Here is Wade. Yes! With 1.3 to go!
Another one of my favorite NBA moments right here. Game winner. First playoff game versus one of, someone I looked up to, someone I respect in Baron Davis, who pushed me to the limits, made me better. But that game winner, my first playoff game, I get no better than that.
5 seconds left. Waiters back to Dwayne. Shoots. No, he couldn't get it off. Now fires it up. Bank it in. It counts. It counts. The Heat win the game. Dwayne Wade won it for Miami. 126-125.
Luckiest shot I ever hit in my life. One-legged game winner versus Golden State. I think Kevin Durant and Steph Curry still on the court looking at me like, what just happened? But just a great way to end my career, you know, to go out that way and hit that game winning shot and get a chance to step up on that table once again and say, this is my house.
I asked on Sunday, so they've been sitting and waiting. Oh, beautiful move by Nowitzki.
Oy, the up fake, up and under. Oy. Let's see, I was older already then. I could barely move. I had to use all my up fakes. Oy. Oh, nice.
Kid to throw it in. Get 5 seconds to do it. Nowitzki, Evans glued to him. Here's Nowitzki for the win. Got it. And the game is over. The game is over. Nowitzki wins it at the buzzer.
Oh. Game winner in Philly. Right shoulder, you know that. And the game is over. It was one of my few game winners at the buzzer.
1 more second is no good. Rebound Dallas. They have not taken the timeout. 12, 11, down by one. Carter back to Mike James. Dennis Carter from Dirk. 5 seconds. Dirk for three. Yes!
It's Chicago, big three at the end to win the game with a couple seconds left.
They could rip the heart out of this Dallas team with a victory here tonight. Wow, how deflating would this loss be for the Mavericks?
21 points for Ginobili, 19 in the second half. Nowitzki goes right at Bowen, and the foul!
Game 7, 06, I'll never forget this. We beat the Spurs at their home court in game 7, and we're down 3, and I make a stumble move to the basket, try to dunk, get fouled, make the free throw. The game goes into overtime, and we beat the Spurs, who always beat up on us.
A wide open, fakes the three, gives to Nowitzki, drives by Ewing to the glass.
Ooh, what?
Dirk Nowitzki with a pump.
One of my few dunks. Hold on, we gotta run that back. Okay, Vin Baker. All right, finals 2011, down, tie game. Three ball, and then the drive. Lefty scoop. Up two, and then Dwayne shot it from half court, and we ended up winning.
game two.
Bobby Sora is able to break down the defense because the guy has recovered.
That was one of my few cuts. I didn't have a lot of cuts, and I'm usually a spot-up guy, but perfect pass.
Here we go. Shot clock is off.
Now the Mavericks should work for the absolute last shot here. And guess who they're sending it to?
Dirk with the game tie with five, with four. Dirk Nowitzki for the lead. He's got it. Dirk knocks it down at the baseline. Nowitzki. And he turned around and high-fived Kobe Bryant.
Clutch shot in L.A., and Kobe was not dressed, so he's on the bench, and I'm shooting the shot, I make it, I'm kind of fading away, and I kind of see him there, so I gave him a little dap, and that was a cool moment that I'll never forget.
Put Dirk on the inbound pass. Yurlenko looking to Darren Williams, he maneuvers away from Dennis George. Oh, it's in! I don't believe it! No timeout for Dallas, 5 seconds to go. Dirk,
another game winner. Utah just tied at 6 seconds to go with a three off the glass, and we didn't have a timeout, and Utah didn't know, so we just pushed the ball up, and I got a wide open three. And that was a big win. Utah was really, really good at the time. Wow, you guys got me going down memory lane.
Yeah, this was game seven against the Spurs. It was crazy. I remember like the second quarter is when I first felt my hamstring. I hurt my hamstring, went back to the locker room. JP, Dennis, all these people that worked for the Clippers at the time was trying to like readjust my hips and all this stuff like that. And eventually we said, just tape it up and we'll see how it goes. And I remember coming out that play at that timeout, and I just told Coach, I was like, let me have the ball, let me have it. And I remember when I made the shot, I was just so excited. I was so excited because that series had no business being a first round series, and we was playing against the Spurs, and it was dope. It was nice to win that game. And I remember after that game, our whole team went in the locker room and watched the Floyd Mayweather fight.
One, two, three.
Yes. The fight is over here. Hey, turn the fight on.
With Matt Barnes and Blake Griffin. Here it is. Chris Paul.
That play right there was against Memphis in the playoffs. It might have been my first or second year in LA with the Clippers. And that was a crazy game because Tony Allen was guarding me. And Tony Allen was always a tough defender. And I don't know, I just felt like I could get to my spot. It was crazy because the time had expired in that one, so that was game, and I think that put us up 2-0 against Memphis.
Then off the screen and roll, you go under, the crossover and the circus shot.
Oh,
that is unbelievable.
I think play of the day is taken care of on SportsCenter tonight.
Man, this was in the playoffs against San Antonio, and I just remember, Doris Burke was calling that game. And I remember when it went in, she was talking, and she was like, oh.
The rim and get close.
So Parker, 23-9.
Oh!
And that goes in.
That was Michael Jordan-esque.
Well, he's an ideal zone breaker with that ability to snipe from the perimeter. Oh, my.
Oh, man. That is some athleticism. Chris Paul taking it right at Dwight Howard.
That was when I dunked on Dwight Howard. That was in Orlando. That was an and one. And anytime kids ask me if I can dunk, I always tell them to YouTube this.
Chris Paul wants screen and roll.
This is...
Can't let him come through that little scene.
This is in Denver when Andre Miller failed. We was off of In and Out, and this is always like on all those little highlight mixtapes or whatever.
Paul with another steal. Here's four for the night. Oh, in between the legs, are you kidding me? And the foul! Yeah, I think he's an all-star.
Yeah, it's funny because that fake spin that I see guys do and stuff now, I always tell them I started doing that way back when I played in New Orleans.
Finds Paul with two, with one. Paul for the win!
Oh, I remember this. I remember this. This was on Martin Luther King Day. It was an early game. It was an early game against Indiana.
1-2 pick and roll, Harden and Paul. Oh, Chris Paul. Ooh, it's got to go in, Smitty. It's got to go in.
I remember he went for the crossover, and I just remember lining my shot up like, you got to make it.
It's got to go in, Smitty. It's got to go in, it's Smitty.
And here comes Paul. Oh.
This right here, when I threw the ball between Jason Terry's leg, this was the night of my shoe release. So I had all Jordan brand, all my homies in town. And I remember after that game, I was having a party for my shoe release.
Chris Paul putting on a show.
And that was just the fastest way. Just like this play against Houston when I threw it between Isaiah's legs.
Oh.
A lot of people think that you like trying to make him look bad, but he had me cut off. So the only way I could get past him was to throw the ball through his legs.
Ray Allen. Going deep for the win. Game winner by Ray Allen.
Oh, yeah, this one, every time I think about this game winner against the Suns, it always reminds me of how that night I had, I think, 41 or 42, and I had a lot in the fourth quarter, and everybody, we were sitting on the back of the bus getting ready to go back to the hotel, and guys were like, man, you are killing it out there tonight. Like, it was awesome. And then my other teammate, one of my teammates goes, yo, Kobe Bryant has 61 points in three quarters. I was like, what?
The second greatest performance in NBA history. And an 81-point game, 55 in the second half.
I was like, leave it up to Kobe to outdo me on a night like this. And that was the night he had 81.
Sherman Douglas with a bullet pass to Ray Allen. Jake on the line.
This is one of my favorite dunks, because I made it look so simple when I went to the hole and I reversed at the baseline, and I just contorted my body. And when I ran down the floor, nobody really knew who I was. And, you know, we weren't, as a team, nobody was talking about us. And then that highlight was like, wow, okay, so that guy just did that.
Pass deflected by Eddie House, kicked off by Pierce. Ray Allen for the game. Got it at the buzzer.
This game winner against the Bobcats is one of the funniest ones, because we had no business winning this game, and they just make a mistake at the end and turn the ball over. But the funniest thing about this clip is, as much as we're celebrating, you have to watch everybody else's faces. The fans, like, they want to just, they throw their hands up, and it's just hilarious to watch when it goes in. Who was that? Oh, man. Raymond Feldman falls to the ground. They just couldn't believe it, but that was so funny.
Jay still battling, but unable to finish.
Full court shot. The interesting thing about this shot is I shot it from the free throw line at the other side, literally at the free throw line. And now I try to do that, because I've tried to do it before. I was like, I can't even get the ball up in the air and touch the rim on the other side. But, you know, it's just something about when you're playing in the game, how you're, you know, just something else takes over and you're able to make plays.
Allen shaking it. Oh, my goodness.
This right here, for me, I just remember coming down the lane, just dunking, and that's all I ever wanted to do was dunk on somebody. I wasn't really confident in my shooting yet, but I knew I was going to get to the hole whenever I could.
Ray Allen brings it into front court. Kobe Bryant riding him right up on his belt. Out beyond the three-point arc with 11. Gets a screen from Radmanovic with 9. Spins away from Grant, drives into the lane, and the glass goes up and under, and lays it in!
This was like one of my first games after being traded to Seattle. I was excited for a new journey, but the same token, I was nervous because, you know, I'm replacing, you know, Gary Payton in Seattle. People loved him.
Boy, it's going to be a fun night here at Key Arena. Gary Payton coming back for the first time since the trade for Ray Allen. The fans are jacked. It's sold out. We'll have a preview for you coming up next.
Ray Allen, we're trying to get in. This is how. Have a good fucking night. Don't get hurt.
You know, when the Lakers come to town, everybody's there. They want to see who I am, what we're made of, and, you know, it's myself against Kobe. You know, how am I going to stand up? And that was one of the beginning plays, moves, shots that I think people recognize and say, well, okay, we got, you know, we have a guy that can play a little bit.
It's the rebound. Dunks it with 3.5 seconds to go.
This one right here, this is one of my favorites, because I remember at the end of the game, you know, we had to get two, the game's tied. We go down, and I score. And T-Mac actually fouls me as I go to the lane, and the ref doesn't call it. He fouls me. I make the free throw. The game's over with. And the series over.
And then letting him go to work. Rose is on Rondo. Allen. Over Noah. Oh! Ray Allen has done it again!
This is one of my favorite game winners. I mean, these playoffs here were so fun for me. You know, we were down a man because Kevin was hurt. And we were going back and forth with Chicago all series. And that shot, you know, I wasn't open. Noah's 7 feet tall. And, you know, he just hesitated a little bit, and I still got it off forward.
Should the Spurs foul? Should Miami go for the three right away? Just attack the basket. James catches, puts up a three. Won't go. Rebound Bosch. Back out to Allen. His three-pointer. Bang! Tie game with 5 seconds remaining.
So this moment was like, it was so crazy. You know, just thinking about where we were at that time, it just felt like it slipped away from us at the end. We turned the ball over, and it just seemed like it was meant to happen this way, because I was always ready to take that shot, and I had worked on that shot so many times that day. I do believe there needs to be a 30 for 30, and we need to call it 28 seconds. I think that's the time. And just talk about everything that happened in those seconds, because you can give a masterclass on, you know, things that you want to do at the end of games, you know, talking about making free throws and who should be in the game, who shouldn't be in the game. And it can go either direction. With Chris's versatility, for him to be able to get the rebound, I think that's the biggest play of this whole scenario.
Calvin, 6 to play. Booker, this is for the win. Got it! Wow!
I remember sitting in my hotel room watching this in the bubble. Booker, D. Book's game winner against the Clippers in the bubble. It's crazy. He falling down too as time expires with two great defenders on him, and he still made it. That was tough.
At the shot, actually deflected by Hopper. Olajuwon with a spectacular move.
Well, we're going back in the day. I'm looking at the camp. Obviously, we know what he did his whole career. I mean, he gets off the he gets an offensive rebound, and I mean, he just puts a beautiful spin move. I think this was the NBA Finals. Yeah, it was the NBA Finals. I was just born, actually, a couple months earlier. So, I mean, that's just a beautiful spin move.
Finds Barrett. Get a shot up. This is for the win. Oh! It's good! Off the window!
No, this is me.
Yeah.
Off the glass for the game. All my teammates said they thought I was gonna miss. Nah, JT, I had to get you back. You fouled me on top of it. It was definitely a foul. But you got me. You got me. It was either my second or my third game as a rookie, so it was payback.
Looking for Tatum. Gets it in. Tatum's back. 10 seconds. The three. Got it. Jason Tatum with 1.3 to go.
And watch that one more time. Good pass, AD. Yeah, no, all my teammates thought I was gonna miss. That's why everybody was standing around like that. I knew it was gonna end up. That's tough. Yeah, that's definitely my favorite bucket.
And interestingly, alley-oop to Bryant. Oh, what a play from Bryant!
We going back to the 2010 finals. Boston against Kobe. Boston against the Lakers, and we got Kobe trying to post up, and you know, and obviously Paul Pierce was denying him, and you know, the best thing to do in that situation is to kind of go for the spin move. And but then again, you gotta have a great chemistry with your teammate for them to be able to understand, you know, this type of situation, that, you know, that's why they won all those championships, because you got someone that were so good like him, and you also got a bunch of great teammates around him, and that made him better, and that he also made better. And And that was a result of, you know, all those championships.
With 4 minutes to play. Jordan, crossover.
Oh, slam. Excuse me. I'm sorry. Oh, my God.
I don't think people understand the difficulty and how athletic and how big of hands you have to be able to cross over, gather off a jump stop, and dunk the ball over a 7-footer. This is like a move that not many people could do. Like hop step into a bounce, dunk the ball, hang in the air. You gotta have huge hands, and you gotta just be athletic out this world.
Werther plays, steal, he kept it in bounds. Here it is again. Oh!
Oh yeah, this one was crazy. This was kind of luck too, to do something like this with like being off balance, running full speed, somebody trying to block it is, it was a little bit of luck, but he did this so often that it was like it had to be a skill. And when I think about being in these types of situations, like sometimes you even fall over. So the fact that he was able to take the contact and still make it is crazy. With that type of English on it.
Green, they angles up toward the rim and gives her feet, he'll turn, got off the shot and hit it. Oh my, he's gonna count the bucket.
He doesn't get better than a game winner in the playoffs. This game especially, we were, you know, up 2-0. We didn't play well that whole game. We just really got lucky. And, James ended up, I think he fouled out. Yeah, he did foul out. So we were missing him. And, you know, we just try to, you know, do the best shot possible. And just got an opportunity to, you know, go out and, you know, hit the game winner, which I did. That wasn't a revenge from 3 years ago, but it felt really good to be able to do it in Toronto, especially after the same I lost, you know, against Toronto, you know, 3 years earlier.
Teammates. Phillips unable to play this past summer. His wife Piper giving birth to their child. Oh, my goodness! A whirling dervish with cycle. My goodness.
This is a move that I remember watching him do, and I practice it. To this day, it's one of the moves that, for some reason, it just become a second nature move for me. But that was just his ability to shot create, no matter who was on him, no matter the time of the game. He was one of the best at it.
Hudson, Williamson, Berry, Phillips, Hamilton, Johnson, a screen out high. One-on-one basketball. Chauncey's got to hurry. Fires.
So this play right here is my first year in Detroit. I'm playing for Coach Rick Carlisle. And it was kind of my first opportunity at the end of games. When I signed there the year before, Chucky Atkins, who was a dear friend of mine, was the starting point guard. I signed to be the starting point guard, and I was starting. And Rick Carlisle, for some reason, at the end of games, he would play Chucky the last 4 minutes. So I had a meeting with him, and I'm like, Coach, I'm the only starting point guard in the league that's not playing at the end of the game. And he shared with me that he was just confident in Chucky and this and that. And I was like, well, I'm pretty good at the end of games too, but you'll never know. Give me a chance.
Shot after shot this year, another one. Oh, you got me, Chucky! Chauncey, you are crazy! Chauncey rises. Got it! Got a five. I'm firing the three. Yes!
Ironically, this was one of the first games that he gave me a chance. And obviously it was a big time game. We were at home. I got the ball, shot clock running down, me ISO against Chris Mills, one of my former teammates. And that's just a shot that I love. The rock shot. And that was a big moment for me because obviously I proved to my coach that I could be good in those situations. That was a big point in my career, actually.
Walton can tip it. Bryant with the save.
Oh, you gotta get a shot here.
Final seconds. Bryant for the win. Bang!
Kobe, game winner versus Phoenix. I remember watching this game. This whole sequence, even beforehand, when he sent in the overtime, when he got the little Euro step floater to tie the game up. I knew he was gonna make this. I just knew he was gonna get to a spot, raise up, knock it down. No question, I had no doubt in my mind that he was gonna make this shot, but I knew he wanted to get to that right elbow, the way he was dribbling, and get to a spot and make it, but I remember watching this game.
Launch down by four. Denver trying to get organized defensively. Morris now. Oh, fake it behind the back, and Trey lays it in.
Oh, this is one of my favorite plays because it's on my teammate, high school teammate, Michael Porter. This is something I'll be able to talk to him until we're old and not playing anymore. I actually hit him on his butt on my way back. So it was fun. It's my brother, for real. So that's what made that play so special.
So how are they going to find an answer for this man right here? Oh, my goodness. No, he didn't.
With a little shake of his shoulder.
No, he
didn't. Hits the three.
No, he didn't.
Yeah. This is in the playoffs. One of my favorite moments. A lot of people think I was shrugging and shimmying, but I was really just relaxing my shoulders and be able to knock it down.
Point. Let's see how they play this.
Here is Young. Finds his spot. Young on the floater, puts it in.
Yeah. That was so fun of a game. The whole game was so fun. The play actually broke down after John's shoe fell off. And I just had to kind of make a move. It was just a fun game.
Herter gets it in. Kevin looking. Lob to the basket. Poked away. Trey!
Oh, this is a game winner. I had the play was actually for John, and it just the ball happened to come to me, and I grabbed it with my left and switched it to the right. If I had to do that again, I don't know if I'd make it, but happy I did at that time.
Throw it out of bounds. Corky Jenks spots Zach Lyon. Put that one into the dunk contest. The 360 slam.
360 in game. A little dunk. I think this was before I was doing the dunk contest, so I was trying to like just let everybody know I was coming to win it again.
Guarding you, Devin Booker will always get good looks.
Look out! The high flying, dazzling Zach LaVine.
This is one of my first like real posters. One of my first big posters, really. Like I got a lane in Phoenix. I was in Minnesota, and it was pretty much just Monty Mano and the big guy. And you know they get the block shots. You know sometimes on those, and sometimes you make them. But I was able to. You know, climb over the top of them and throw it in. It's funny, so we're playing in their arena actually, and they played the replay in their arena, and I've never seen that before.
You know, I hate to call out a Phoenix Sun, but Alex, you just got posterized there. I mean, you got to give it where it's due.
LaVine, he goes right by.
Oh! Stop it, Sampson! Did you not get the memo?
This was like one of the first dunks coming back off my ACL injury. You know, devastating coming back from me working hard, and I really didn't get to, you know, get up like that for a while. So I found the lane, and my body was just getting back into it. And, you know, I just told him not to jump. Like, you know, you remember who I am.
Well, it doesn't look like he's having any issues coming back from his ACL, does it?
Another guy you can't help off of if you're on defense. He's only going to get better. That was really nice. Ooh, that was nice.
You know, quick back door. Catching big guys, you know, at the wrong spot at the wrong time. It's their job to go up there and contest the shot. It's my job to put them on a poster sometimes.
Get hot in a hurry. Crossover, Mitchell into a reach.
No! Oh! He came in hot and went up high.
Oh man, I remember this one against the Rockets. I had a bad shooting night this game, so this was that was definitely one that I was definitely happy about, just because it kind of caught me by surprise. And I even caught it. I've done that before, but never like in a game like that.
Well, and they're competing too. They're competing at both ends.
Oh, Donovan. Oh! Climbing up and popping the rim!
I haven't seen this dunk in a while. One against the Mavericks. It's kind of like my signature, my favorite. You know, throw it right to left and just try and go up and jump over what's in front of me.
Runs it to Burks. Catch and shoot three. No. Rebound. Oh! My! I gotta see that over and over again.
Up on the ladder. This was my first one.
Donovan Mitchell brings it down.
I feel like that dunk really like put me into like Spider. Like that's where that name really started to kind of go and pick up from there.
Mitchell posterizes the big, throwing it down on McGee.
There's just times where, like, you see a big man, you have to finish over them. Otherwise, they're blocking your shot. That's kind of how it is with going against Rudy, which I've only done once, but like that's how it is in practice. But like when you get guys like JaVale like that, you gotta just jump over him.
Leads back, sent off balance, no foul, outside the spin, stripped of the ball by Pierce, sends it ahead to Barrett, too far ahead, he saves it, he'll lay it in, oh, you gotta love that action!
Good steal by Ricky, he saves it, next you know, I get a great pass to make up what he was messing up. He threw the ball too far right here, but hey, look at the glove, watch how I get it, bang, ooh, between the leg and got it right there to him. You see what I'm saying? That's what I like. I like it when I do things like that.
And not a very good shot. Porter up with the ball. Flipped it ahead there for Strickland. Stolen by Gary Payton. Flipped the ball to Kendall Gill. What a play.
Okay. Ooh. I ripped my guy, Strickland. Oh, on the knees. Look. Ooh. And I threw it up. That's just good anticipation. I knew what I was doing.
And Payton going to push it in a hurry. Top of the key, works his way around. Oh, what a move by Gary Payton.
Oh, I'm sorry about this, Hornacek. Oh, man, I don't know what I was doing. I just crossed you over. My bad, buddy. He knows, oh, you was going for it. I tricked you. Gotcha.
That is as terrific a move as you will ever see.
Underneath the Payton. Throw!
Oh! Okay, this is a Phoenix. Oh, give it to me. Oh, Chambers, I'm sorry. I don't know. I just fooled you right here. You thought you was going to block it, but look what happened. Ooh, gotcha. Uh-oh. Off the glass. Two.
About the fact that the guards will strike a lot of times, and there's one of the key turnovers triggered by the Seattle defense. Between the legs to Sean Kemp.
I was showing out right here. Come on, Sean. There it is. And get you a dunk, buddy. All right. I was just showing out. Just trying to have some fun. Get back in the game, that's all.
Gets it to Anderson. And the steal. He had Kevin Edwards. With good anticipation. Payton with a beauty to count.
Okay. Ooh. That's a steal by me. Give it to me, Dennis. Okay. Uh-oh. Around the back. Ooh. Woo. Showing out again. That's me. Oh. And then look at me. I'll get away. Oh, Sean get a dunk. He used to make me look good.
It was on a ladder because he was suspended in the air for quite a while. Payton out of control, but he scores. He'll do that. He'll flip it over the back of his head and look.
Detroit, first of all, I thought I was gonna fall. But you see, when I got hit, bang, right here. Oh, I got him. And then I threw it. I lost the ball, really, but it went in.
Nate McMillan ahead. Payton releasing early to Barcelona's.
Got a little mustard on that baby.
Okay. All right. Oh. Marshallonis, that's my guy. I did it, look, between leg, and then blocked him off so he can get a layup. Good play.
It's amazing how much information Matt can pick up on those. Payton with the steal, he puts it down.
Yeah, we in the finals. Oh, don't rip him like that, ask you. And then Michael come down. I'm going to dunk on you. Dunk. And then, look, ask you rips him. I get it, tip it, Mike running from me. I got to dunk it because I don't know what you're going to do. It's a wrap. Showtime.
Edwards has played great. Towns has played great. D'Angelo Russell has 16 points, 7 assists, 7 rebounds.
Ant looking for even more. He's not satisfied. Not by a long shot.
All right, this is my step back versus Denver Nuggets. When I caught the ball, Pat Bev was just like, go at him, go at him. So, I mean, when Pat Bev giving you that type of energy, you ain't got no choice but to make the shot.
After foul, down by 2. Oh, Butler knocked it away. Here's Hero with 8 seconds left for 3. Yes! Oh, my!
My shot against Philly my rookie year. Jimmy stole the ball from Joel, and I dribbled down with, like, 6 seconds left. We were down 2, and I just stepped back and pulled the 3 and went in. But yeah, this was crazy. This was definitely one of my favorite, you know, NBA moments so far. The arena was rocking. There was a lot of people in there. This was definitely exciting.
Lillard, a chance to send the Thunder home. Lillard, long range 3, and it's good.
the buzzer! Damian Lillard!
My game winner against OKC, game five. I done seen this so many times. Every time I see this, one thing that never changes is I can't believe how deep I was sometimes. Like, I actually shot that. That actually was a bad shot. But Seth Curry, when the play is happening, Seth Curry is telling a bench, like, this is game. Like, he was telling them the game was over. And then after I made the shot, you see him turn around and stare at him like, I told you so. And he told me that after the game, but then on the tape, when you look at it, you can actually see him, like, talking to him, and then you see him turn around and stare at him. So that's, like, a story you don't see. And also CJ, you see him in the corner telling me to go because he don't know what I'm thinking standing that far from the basket as time is running out. I love to watch the fans' reaction, just, like, how excited they were when we won this game.
Gave it up. Threw it away. LeBron foot race with Jefferson. Nobody's going to catch up. Look out.
Yo! I don't think this dunk get talked about enough. How far he jumped in game. Like, he could have easily cleared the free throw line. How much room he even had. Like, the momentum he had carrying. This dunk does not get talked about enough. He's one of the most incredible in-game dunks that I've definitely seen.
That triggers the rush the other way by Nash. Oh, what a pass. Back. Yeah!
You got to make that shot after you get that kind of stuff from Steve Nash. You can't miss that one.
All right, this is just a play in transition, trying to push the ball, put pressure on the defense. If someone went reached, I think that was Baron Davis, my good buddy, put it behind my back, crossed over, and then realized that I had Raja in the corner for an open three, but if I took time to go back across my body, it would have taken time away from him. So I just slung it behind the back. Hopefully it was on the money, and he made the shot.
4:07 seconds left in overtime. The Knicks by two. Miami gets it in. Here's Hardaway looking for the shot. Childs does not want to foul. Hardaway fires and hits! Missed. Allen two times.
Now you gotta make sure they don't get a three off.
Lou crossing over, floats. Oh, at the horn. My goodness, they're going to look at it, but I think it's going to count.
I remember this, too. Down 2 points, and LeBron missed a free throw with 6 seconds, and I crossed Larry Hughes over and shot a floater, and Bron tried to block the shot, and he missed it. And then I started talking trash to my homeboy Abe, who's in the crowd, who's Larry Hughes' best friend, and me and Larry grew up together because we're from Missouri. So to be able to make that move, you know, on Larry and then make the floater and talk stuff to Abe, that was a pretty fun night.
Sign of holding Denver to 21 points. Good. Early on and over.
I remember catching the ball. I remember we used to always practice the catch and go. And I remember when John Lucas passed me the ball, I tried to catch in the momentum so I could just get to the basket. As soon as I seen big fella in the court, I was like, either he gonna foul me or I'm gonna catch him. And I just remember just going up, just trying to throw it in. I was shocked for a second after the dunk because I wasn't sure if it went in, because people don't realize how big he was, but that was a good one. I caught him that game.
Pistons need a three, and they have just under 3 seconds to do it. Here's Chauncey Phillips. Here it is. He's got it. He's got it. Chauncey Phillips hits the three.
So this play here is a shot that I hit in a game the year that we won the NBA championship in 2004. It was against the New Jersey Nets, who were the beast of the East. They had won the Eastern Conference 2 years in a row. They swept us the year before, and this was an incredible series. Kerry Kittles was running at me, and I just wanted to get a clean look at the shot, and I ended up making the shot, and it was off the glass. I can't tell you that I could do it again, but it was fun. The building went crazy, but unfortunately, we ended up losing that game, and it took a little bit of the mojo out of it, but it was a big-time shot in my career.